The state opposition is demanding the government come clean on how it plans to fully fund the first portion of the suburban rail loop. It's arguing there must be a secret plan to tax Victorians. More from Heidi Murphy.
Debate about Labor's signature project reignited outside Box Hill Hospital.
Now, Daniel Andrews doesn't seem to understand that money doesn't grow on trees. It's paid for by taxpayers.
The business case has funding coming a third from the state budget, a third from the Commonwealth, the final bit, value capture, which can be anything from a new levy through to the lease or sale of newly created property.
He's going to put new taxes in, big new taxes, nasty new taxes.
Not true, says the government, pointing out it has consistently ruled out a sting on individuals, saying the value capture mechanisms are targeted at large property developers who stand to make huge windfall profits. It is the same pot of money the opposition's counting on.
A Liberal and Nationals government will take that $35 billion and invest every single cent of it into health.
But it has been raised.
No, a large amount, there have been budget allocations made to this project and we will reallocate all of those.
Labor's focus today, future childcare spots in the northern suburbs in partnership with Moreland Council. The minister refusing to toy any further with the coalition's idea of moving hospital patients to Mickleham.
Mickleham is not purpose-built as a health option. It's there as a quarantine centre.
The government says it did actively consider the idea for a significant period of time but had to rule it out on clinician advice. The opposition is asking for that advice to be made public.
This is a very simple common sense approach for low care need patients.
We are politicians, we are not clinicians.
Heidi Murphy, Nine News.